In this lesson, we will discuss the fluid property called density. Density, which is denoted by the Greek symbol rho, is a measure of a fluid's mass concentration. It is defined as the mass of a fluid M divided by the volume it occupies, V. The SI units of density are kilograms per cubic meter, and the British gravitational units are slugs per cubic foot. There are two other parameters related to density that are commonly used in fluid mechanics. The specific weight, denoted by the Greek letter gamma, is the density times the gravitational acceleration g. It represents the weight concentration of a fluid, and its units are weight per volume. The SI units of specific weight are newtons per cubic meter, and the BG units are pounds force divided by cubic feet. The specific gravity of a fluid is its density divided by a reference density. For liquids, this reference density is usually the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius, which is 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter. And specific gravity is unitless. In general, the density of a fluid is a function of both pressure and temperature. For liquids, density is insensitive to moderate changes in pressure. For example, the density of water at 100 kilopascals and 0 degrees Celsius is 999.8 kilograms per cubic meter. If the pressure were increased by 2 orders of magnitude to 10,000 kilopascals, the density would increase by only 0.5%. In fluid mechanics, it is usually assumed that the density of a liquid is constant as it is being compressed. In other words, liquids are incompressible. The density of a gas is sensitive to changes in both pressure and temperature. Experiments show that if the pressure of a gas is low relative to its critical pressure, and its temperature is high relative to its critical temperature, the ideal gas law provides a good approximation for the relationship between density, pressure, and temperature. Fortunately, the ideal gas law is a good approximation for many everyday engineering applications. There are a few ways to express the ideal gas law. The form that is most useful for fluid mechanics states that the pressure of a gas is equal to its density times its specific gas constant R times the temperature. It is important to remember that you must use the absolute pressure and absolute temperature when using this equation. Additionally, this equation should never be used with liquids.